JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for October the 14th. I am Charalambos, Pissouros, head of research here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded lower against all but one of the other major currencies on Wednesday and during the Asian session today. It eked out some gains only against the Japanese yen, while it underperformed the most against the Aussie, the Swiss franc, and the Kiwi in that order. Now, the strengthening of the risk-linked Aussie and Kiwi and the weakening of the dollar and the yen suggest that trading turned to risk-on yesterday and today in Asia. The only reaction that doesn't fit the equation is the strengthening of the Swiss franc. Now, looking at the performance in the equity world, we see that indeed most major European indices traded in the green, with relative optimism rolling into the US session as well. The only exceptions were Italy's FTSE MIB and Spain's IBEX 35, which slid, as well as Wall Street's Dow Jones, which finished virtually unchanged. Investors' appetite remained supported during the Asian session today as well. European stocks rose perhaps due to the bloc's most valuable tech company, SAP, raising its full-year outlook for a third time. And as French luxury goods maker LVMH revealed that sales at its fashion and leather goods division rose strongly during the third quarter. What may have also helped investors' morale may have been China's trade data, with exports surprisingly accelerating in September. Wall Street and Asian markets remained somewhat supported as well, despite the US CPI data revealing that headline inflation unexpectedly ticked up, and even after the minutes of the latest FOMC gathering revealed that policymakers continued to judge that the risks around the inflation projections were tilted to the upside. In our view, yesterday's market action may have been another short covering activity, or in the absence of any fresh negative headlines, investors may have indeed become confident to add more stocks to their portfolios. However, we are reluctant to conclude that the downside is over and that we are back in uptrend mode. After all, the fundamental outlook has not changed yet. Oil prices, despite pausing their rally, remain elevated, meaning that inflation could still accelerate further, thereby resulting in faster tightening by central banks. Indeed, following yesterday's US CPIs and the Fed minutes, market participants brought even forth their expectations of when the committee may hit the hike button for the first time since the pandemic outbreak. According to the Fed Fund futures, a 25 basis points rate increase is now nearly fully priced in for November 2022. Now, today we get the US PPIs for September, with both the headline and core year-over-year rates expected to have risen further, something that could intensify concerns over more acceleration in consumer prices in the months to come. That's why we believe that any additional recovery in equity markets could stay short-lived, and another setback could be possible. As for the US dollar, we expect it to rebound soon and resume its prevailing uptrend. Now, as for the rest of today's events, during the Asian session today, we got Australia's employment report for September. The economy lost more jobs than anticipated, while the unemployment rate slid, but due to more people being discouraged to apply for unemployment benefits. This may have been a reality check for those who have recently started to place bets that the RBA might hike rates later next year. despite the bank itself keep stating that any such move is unlikely before 2024. The Aussie pulled back at the time of the release, and yet it still was the main gainer among the major currencies. This confirms our view that the currency may be more sensitive and linked to the broader market sentiment than developments surrounding local monetary policy. Later in the day, at the same time with the US PPIs, we get the nation's initial jobless claims for last week, with expectations pointing to a small decline. The Energy Information Administration report on crude oil inventories for last week is also coming out, and the forecast suggests a 0.702 million barrels inventory build after a 2.346 million rise the week before. Now, as for the speakers, we have five on today's agenda, and those are ECB executive member, executive board member Frank Elderson, Bank of England MPC member Silvana Denreiro, Atlanta Fed President Raphael Bostic, Richmond Fed President Thomas Barkin, and New York Fed President John Williams. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.